Donald Trump said he would encourage Russia to attack NATO allies if they don't pay their bills, which is not how NATO works. Meanwhile, a special counsel decided to attack President Biden's aide in a report clearing him of any wrongdoing. For more on this, it's time for a closer look. As you may recall, if you haven't already deleted the first Trump presidency from your brain, America's closest allies were not exactly thrilled with his foreign policy. For one thing, he made every interaction with world leaders super uncomfortable, like the time he shoved his way to the front at a NATO summit, like a desperate bridesmaid trying to catch the bouquet, or when he brushed dandruff off the shoulder of French President Emmanuel Macron like a baboon grooming a potential mate, or the time he just seemed to refuse a request for a handshake with Germany's then Chancellor Angela Merkel. I love how they're all shouting at him like he's a golden retriever who forgot his trick. Come on, Donald, shake, shake, handshake. I swear he was doing it just a minute ago. Handshake. This is so awkward. Handshake. I'd say he was lost deep in thought, except it's Trump. He's never deep in thought. If you could see his thought bubble, it would always be exactly what he's doing in that moment. Now, that was in 2017, but he does have that faraway look in his eyes, like he already knows he's gonna get indicted 4 times. That's the face of a man who's silently counting up all the felonies he's committed. Hush money, fraud, and don't forget all the classified documents in your bathroom. I went in there to wash my hands and said, Gott in Himmel, this guy is handshake? Maybe if we had some sort of treat. Of course, the only world leader Trump ever seemed comfortable with was Russian President Vladimir Putin. When he met with Putin in Helsinki, Trump looked happier than he's ever looked in his life. He's smiling like a guy on Maury who just heard the words, you're not the father, or you are the father if the child in question was Vladimir Putin. Trump would be so psyched if Putin was his son. All his other kids would know Vlad was his favorite. Hey, Dad, are you coming to my school plate? Nope, Vlad's got a judo tournament. Not gonna miss that. Then after judo, shirtless horse show. Now, I will say, I do not think Trump is some sort of secret Kremlin agent, mainly because he'd be a horrible spy. For one thing, the man has no stealth. He's the loudest and slowest human being alive. This is a man who literally eclipsed the Queen. Another legendary moment in Trump diplomacy. He made the Queen disappear. Trump's affinity for Putin is much more straightforward. He has well-documented financial ties to Russia. He admires dictators and autocrats. And most of all, he likes anyone who flatters him, doesn't matter who they are. If Usher had endorsed Trump, Trump would have been on stage with him at the Super Bowl halftime show yesterday, which wouldn't have been weird at all because they both have great dance moves. But at a rally on Saturday, Trump took his affinity for Putin to shocking new levels when he said he would encourage Russia to attack NATO allies if those countries don't pay their bills, which is not how NATO works.
NATO was busted until I came along. I said, everybody's going to pay. They said, well, if we don't pay, are you still going to protect us? I said, absolutely not. They couldn't believe the answer. And everybody, you never saw more money pour in. They all owed money, and they wouldn't pay it. I came in, I made a speech, and I said, you gotta pay up. They asked me that question. One of the presidents of a big country stood up and said, well, sir, if we don't pay and we're attacked by Russia, will you protect us? I said, you didn't pay, you're delinquent? He said, yes, let's say that happened. No, I would not protect you. In fact, I would encourage them to do whatever the hell they want. You gotta pay. You gotta pay your bills. I said, no, no, you have to understand. You don't pay your bills, you get no protection. It's very simple.
I would say he sounds like a mobster threatening a pizza place on Mulberry Street, but mobsters never lay it out that clearly. Hey, nice place you got here. It would be a shame if something happened to it. What I'm getting at is if you don't give us protection money, some bad people might give you some trouble. When I say bad people, I do mean us. We would be the ones, we would mess it up. If you don't give us money, we would be the ones who mess. I would just want to hate to leave that out without being crystal clear before I leave. You know, it's not even really protection money. It's just, I want your money, and if you don't give it to me, I'm going to break your windows. Capiche? Oh, and by the way, when I say capiche, I mean understand. I would hate for that to be the part right at the end to be the reason you don't fully comprehend me.
Also, Trump's message to NATO is pretty rich coming from a guy who brags
all the time about not paying his bills. The guy has stiffed everyone from banks to the IRS to hundreds of contractors who worked on his casinos to his own lawyers. Even Rudy Giuliani said in a recent bankruptcy filing that Trump owes him millions in unpaid legal fees. Rudy should try Trump's NATO argument against Trump and see how that works out. Mr. Trump, if you don't pay your bills, I won't be your lawyer anymore. You got a deal, Rudy. Excellent. Wait a second. Oh, no, Rudy, you dope. Also, let's remember that Trump is the guy who famously claimed not paying your bills makes you a genius. Remember?
He didn't pay any federal income tax. So
that makes
if
me
he's
smart.
Paid...
First of all, actually smart people never have to say the words, that makes me smart. I don't remember a scene from Oppenheimer where Einstein says, you know, I got the big brain. Or maybe he does. I haven't finished Oppenheimer yet. I'm watching it. I'm watching it in 2-hour chunks. I'm just kidding. I did finish it. It was one of my favorite movies of the year. The only downside was when it was over, all my plans were dead. I'm just mad I wasn't in it. Everybody was in it. I could have been in it. I could have been an Oppenheimer. You think you're better than me? Also, let's not forget, that's not even how NATO works. NATO members have all agreed to spend a certain amount of their budget on defense. It's not a membership club with fees. Trump's confusing the North Atlantic Treaty Organization with Blockbuster. And by the way, if you want to quibble with NATO policies like spending targets, fine, that's fair game. But it's dangerous and insane to just announce that you'd encourage a Russian invasion because you're annoyed at certain NATO members, especially if you're the guy who claims to be the anti-war candidate. It's one of Trump's favorite talking points on the campaign trail, although sometimes he seems to forget what year he's in. And by the way, while you're watching this, don't worry, you're not going crazy. Trump's campaign plays this dramatic music during his speeches for some reason.
We have a man who is totally corrupt and the worst president in the history of our country, who is cognitively impaired, in no condition to lead, and is now in charge of dealing with Russia and possible nuclear war. Just think of it. We would be in World War II very quickly.
Biden is going to lead us into World War II, the first Great Depression, and scariest of all, Y2K.
Really did some work on cognitively there. So Trump would like to dismantle the international order that has been in place since the first World War II and encourage Russia to attack whoever they want, which, of course, is a shocking development. It seems like it would be huge news in the presidential campaign. But instead, many in the media have long been distracted by a far more urgent story, Biden's age.
As the president, now the oldest in U.S. history, prepares for the 2024 election, concerns grow about his age.
The age issue has been a topic for President Biden in a way that it has not been for his likely opponent, Donald Trump.
The one thing that Joe Biden cannot impact is his age. And that age issue is going to become greater and greater.
I think that the age issue.
The age issue.
The age question.
The age question.
The age question. I call it the vitality issue.
A lot of people are saying Joe Biden's too old.
Joe Biden is not going to not be older next year. He gets older every single day.
At this rate, the headline of the New York Times front page is going to be Breaking Biden One Day Older, Democrats Fear Ceaseless March of Time. The latest furor over Biden's age was ignited by a Republican attorney, Robert Hur, who was originally appointed by Trump and who served as the special counsel looking into Biden's handling of classified documents. Hur issued a report clearing Biden of any wrongdoing, but then added in what seemed to be a very gratuitous hypothetical about Biden's age.
The report clears him legally, but could damage him, obviously, politically, including a passage which reads, and I quote, Mr. Biden would likely present himself to a jury, as he did during our interview with him, as a sympathetic, well-meaning, elderly man with a poor memory.
If that kind of language was appropriate in a legal finding, then prosecutors could have done the same thing to Trump. Robert Mueller could have said, we can't charge the president with obstruction of justice because he would likely present himself to jurors as a demented weirdo who doesn't know what city he's in, forgets how to shake hands, and can't remember how to spell his wife's name or his own name. Again, I'm not saying Biden's age is not fair game. It is. On Thursday, for example, Biden complained about the special counsel report and said the media should look into the origins of the report. But even he couldn't say the word origins.
I hope they now go and take a look at the oranges of the investigation, the beginnings of that investigation. You look at the origin of the investigation. The Mueller report, I wish, covered the oranges, how it started.
Oh, shoot, I got the guys mixed up. I hope this doesn't end up being the top story. That, of course, was Trump struggling to say the words origins. And Trump's mind has only continued to devolve since then. Over the weekend, he claimed that if he loses in November, the state of Pennsylvania will have a new name.
If you live in this Commonwealth, register everyone you know and get them out to vote. We have to win in November, or we're not going to have Pennsylvania. They'll change the name. They're going to change the name of Pennsylvania.
Hi, Mom. Yeah, I'm worried about Grandpa. Yeah, he says they're going to change the name of Pennsylvania if we lose World War II, and he keeps asking for oranges. Trump and Biden are both old. It is not ideal. That's the choice. And as for the special counsel report, two things can be true. It was a political hit job, but also the reality is 86% of Americans think Biden is too old for another term. So Biden has to prove them wrong. That is his job as a presidential candidate. He should make more public appearances, do more rallies, more speeches, more interviews. Hell, maybe Biden should get up there on stage with Usher. Look at his abs, folks. Look at his abs. He's got abs of steel. That's American-made steel right there. Made right here. Made right here in Pennsylvania. We're not changing the name. It's a good name. We're going to keep the name. I'm not kidding around here. The special counsel report was BS, but it's out there now. So Biden has to prove that he's not too old by making more appearances because the stakes are too high. Biden's running against a guy who wants to dismantle American democracy and the international order, a guy who's deranged and deluded in much more dangerous ways. At this point, Trump's brain is basically a basket of rotting
oranges.
This has been a closer look. Hey, everybody, thanks for watching A Closer Look. And as a reminder, my brother Josh and I have started a new podcast called Family Trips with the Meyers Brothers. We hope you listen. We hope you like it. And see you soon.